Hi, my name's Sherri Wall, and I teach economics at the University of Alaska Fairbanks. It is team-based learning, and I am really excited about this way of teaching. I teach in a large auditorium. Typically, I have 125 students in a section, and it's provided me a way to make this really large classroom a lot smaller. But the most exciting thing about it is I see the students learning a lot more than previously when I wasn't using team-based learning. And it creates this very exciting, dynamic classroom environment where the students get to know one another. And but the big thing too, for an economist, we're always looking at opportunity cost, and in this case, it lowers the cost of doing anything in the classroom. You can manually or randomly assign students to a team. They know it's coming. I've set the rules of the game with a syllabus, so they know it's coming. And I have never had a student complain. One student wanted to switch to a different team one time, but we just make sure that the start of the semester they know that we don't allow students to switch between teams. And then after we divide them up in teams, they come to class and they sit together the whole semester, although I do move the teams around in the auditorium so they get exposure to different parts of the classroom. That seems to be a really fluid process. So at the start of the semester, the students seem a little bit tenuous. Maybe they haven't been exposed to some type of team-based learning before, but they slowly start to get to know one another, and it just progresses throughout the semester that when you show up to my class, it just gets louder and louder because they're talking about assignments, they're talking about homework, they're talking about logistics of the class. So I think even the quiet students, they really enjoy this because I might never hear that quiet person's voice in this large auditorium. But then in the team, they're talking with one another. And if we're having a discussion, I can go around and eavesdrop on the teams and I get to hear these voices. So the beauty about team-based learning is I can have the teams talk about this and they might not ever agree with one another, but what I see is they're very polite with one another and hearing each other's voices. And maybe because it is a classroom, they realize that that's kind of a social norm. But I hear very respectful discourse between the students. So more than if I led the discussion for the whole class. I think this can work both in large and small classrooms. If you had a small classroom, even when I've taught in small classrooms, I've always had them do the think, pair, share thing. So it would lower the cost of doing anything because at the start of the semester, they'd already be divided up into groups. Before I knew about team-based learning, when I started any type of activity or project, find a group of people, five to seven people, write your names on a piece of paper, and let's go do this thing. So one of the things that the team-based learning lends itself to is illustrating economic concepts. So there's certain experiments or activities that a lot of professors might use, but having the students divided up into teams facilitates these activities, but also lends itself to even further understanding by the students. One of the things that I do is have the students adopt a country. So they're not just team one, team two, they're New Zealand and Norway and Iceland. And I ask them to look at the economy of that country. What do you think they're doing right? What do you think, what would you try to tell them to do differently? What are some lessons that we can learn from that country? But also one of the, I think it's a pretty common activity for a lot of professors in an Econ 100 class, it's called a trade and exchange game. So you bring bags of goodies in a Ziploc bag and every student gets one. So what I do with this activity now that I have my students divided up into teams that represent countries is first of all we have a round where they look at their bag and just give me a value from 1 to 10 just on how they value the contents of that bag. And with the clicker technology I'm able to capture that information and then we put it into Excel. Then they're allowed to trade within their own country. They can trade the entire bag with one of their countrymates. And then they assess the value again, and we record that. Then we open up for international trade. So they can take the entire bag and trade with other countries. And then we assess the valuation once more. Then the last round, they can open the bag and trade individual contents. And then we assess their happiness or utility one more time with a clicker quiz. What you show, the final Excel graph, is that each round they're getting happier. And that's what we're talking about in economics when we talk about wealth. Wealth is whatever we value. We're always trading for something that we want more. So in this case, we're showing that trade and exchange creates wealth. You're always trading for something that you want more. And it's consumer and producer surplus. So what I see with team-based learning overall, I see higher levels of engagement with the students. I see them thinking critically, which is one of my big objectives for the students. I want them to be critical thinkers when they leave my class. And I see the student retention level has just gone through the roof. I lose just a few students throughout the semester. Most of them stay with the class. So team-based learning, specifically in economics, it lowers the transaction cost of doing any type of activity. They're already in a team. We can have discussions. We can have them explain things to each other. We have time during class to work on the group projects that they're responsible for. It creates this energized, exciting, interactive classroom. We're encouraging students to be active learners versus passive learners, and it's moving the students up the Bloom's taxonomy of learning. This is really important for accreditation these days, and we're just going through the accreditation process. It incorporates the various learning styles. Some students are auditory, visual, kinesthetic, so hopefully we're tapping into all of these types of learning styles as much as we can.